We want to evaluate the following expressions. Looking at this first example, we can think of this two ways. We can just think of this as negative 5, but we can also think of this as the opposite of positive 5, which of course is still just negative 5. But thinking of a negative sign as an opposite can sometimes be helpful, especially on the second example. Again, we can think of this as negative negative 3, but we could also think of this as the opposite of negative 3. Well, the opposite of negative 3 would be positive 3. So negative negative 3 is positive 3. At this point, what we'll notice is if there's an even number of negatives, the result will be positive. And if there's an odd number of negatives, the result will be negative. So for this example, we have 1, 2, 3 negatives, so the result will be negative 1. Or of course, we could still use the reasoning that we did above, working our way from the inside out. This would be the opposite of negative 1, which would be positive 1, and then we have the opposite of positive 1, which would be negative 1. But as there are more and more negatives, the shortcut is very handy. So for this last one, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 negatives. Well, 4 is even. So we know the result here will be positive 8. I hope you found this helpful.